We're here for week two. We have a very, very much more exciting lineup of music this week.
Loaded new music Friday.
Including a DJ that no one knows about. Or
no one knows who he is.
Yeah, he could be one of us. Or
he's ski masked up.
Theoretically, yes. Yeah. He could be one of us. No one knows.
And then we got Flux Pavilion. They're not back, but they're here for this week.
We have to fix this, like, not knowing if it's a group or a single person.
Yeah.
So Flux Pavilion is actually just a person.
It's basically me that keeps fucking.
You got to do your fucking research, dude.
Yeah, that is.
I'm learning. I'm learning now.
Okay.
That's not like
a we got Hell Suit.
It's so once again. It isn't a Flux Pavilion main song. It is
it's a remix.
Hell's Loot remix. So did you do any research? Do you know anything about Hell's Loot?
I like to come in this...
Sounds like a bum.
No.
Kind of blindly.
Sounds like a fucking bum.
I don't want to hear his music and then get...
Well, do you know if it's a he or her or if it's a group?
Oh, that's what you mean. No.
Okay.
We'll refer to them as them.
Yeah, none of us do.
I should refer to it as them.
So, we're going to do the same thing. We added a table this week to give us a little more leverage and support for all our crap.
Yo, name idea for this place.
Little decoration.
The main stage.
I don't love that.
Huh?
I don't love that.
All right. Let's move on.
What do you think?
I kind of liked it.
The main stage?
Yeah. Like, you know, concert, main stage. How about
it was going to be like Chesapeake Bay or something.
Shut the fuck.
We had a fan sent in a potential idea for the room, the watering hole.
Who said that?
I'm out on that.
Who did that?
It was,
Roski.
No, I think it was Dan.
Oh, really?
Watering hole?
I'm out on that.
Oh, all right, okay. So we're still at a standstill then.
Let's throw one more out there. How about the main act?
The main act? I'm out. Hey, if you guys got any ideas, you know, you got our socials, so.
Yeah, we like the creativity from you guys as well.
Send it in, because we're clearly not good at figuring this shit out.
Speaking of, just one more thing. Our mics are, we're having trouble figuring out this mixer, so I don't know if you guys realized last week, the audio kind of changed halfway through, and I don't know what it's going to be for this week, but we're working on it. We have no idea what we're doing, so.
Sitting here toying with that damn mixer for an hour.
Yeah.
So who wants to kick us off?
Let's go same order.
No, I don't want to do that.
All right, I'll start us.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Let's do a little introduction. What's your what do you got for us, Will?
So my song is came out Friday. It's by Weathen called
Do you want to yell any louder into that mic?
It's called Think You Right. It's got two features. Both of which I've never heard of. So,
Did you do your research?
I do know a bit about Weathen.
No, but what about the features?
I do not know about Eric Doe or Glaive, but Weathen. His real name is Ethan. Play on words with Weathen.
Guess?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Ethan.
Guys, my name's Ethan Sandy. My name's Ethan Sandy.
Where do you guys think he's from?
Illinois. Farmfield, Illinois.
What's his last name? Do you know?
It's like Ethan.
Ethan.
Ethan, like Snowwreck or something. I don't know.
What?
I'm guessing European.
European?
London?
Your guess is Illinois?
I'm guessing a
Illinois.
Are you pulling that out of your ass? Because he is from, hails from Chicago, Illinois.
Dead ass.
Yes.
Here's why I guessed it. Because I was thinking Weathen, like a Farmfield. But it was a complete guess.
Bro, what?
It was a complete guess. But it worked.
All right. Well,
anything else on the song, or
I will say, first looks, it's under 2 minutes, which is quick, right?
So it's
that's quick.
So for me, I'm thinking
it's
maybe
a quick hitter.
He's not too proud of his work and needed to cut it short.
I'm thinking
but
doghouse.
I'm excited about the music.
We'll get this one kicked off.
A little doghouse and it works.
Yeah, I'd like to see the music video.
I'll start and say that the first like 10 seconds sounded pretty normal for like a song of his type, and then it kind of flipped quick.
Yeah, it sounded terrible, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, For real, we should let the song play longer.
No, no, we stop it. Give our opinion.
Bro, this is garbage.
Yeah, hit the pause. Hit the pause. Okay, I got two things. Whoever the singer is right now, the vocalist, which one? I mean, there's two of them, so
it's,
I don't know.
It's probably Eric Doa or Glaive.
Bro, it sounds like horrible auto tune right now. Like, dragged on.
It sounds like a shitty, like, kids bop song.
Yeah. It sounds like a computer with, like, a virus. It's just like...
And the beat, it's, like, got a very weird... I think, like, grunge might be the right word. Like,
hey,
kind of emo type of
beat.
There's
only one way to categorize this.
Hold on, hold on. I want to get about 20 more seconds
in.
Yeah,
a little bit more.
The music video is really cringe. I mean, right? These kids look like they're like 14.
They look like TikTokers.
I don't even know if I'd really quantify that as electronic dance music.
I'd quantify that as a song.
I'd quantify that as hot garbage. L.
So, I'm thinking initially out of the ones that we've done for both weeks, this is far and away the worst we've had.
This is
the song?
Yeah.
And I do want to give a quick update.
That
Cascade remix, I like it now.
I was about to say that Cascade remix for me is up there as the worst.
I'm not
really.
Like it,
so you gave it a chance and gave it some listens after.
Dude, last night I threw the music video on, like, showed it to CJ. I like it. I'm just gonna be
so,
honest, I like it.
Was your song a dub or an L last week?
His was an L. Well,
what was mine last week? It was that Jules and Sparks song, which was garbage.
Take me away.
This is another L. I'm trying to think of settings where I could play this song, and it would really only be like around like a big group of closer friends, and you're just trying to like screw around and put on like a shit song.
To, like, fuck with them.
Yeah, that's the only scenario.
Yeah,
I'd, like, anyone who's getting into EDM, I wouldn't show them this song.
It would be, you know, it'd be a tough scenario is, like, if you were around a group of people you never knew, you didn't know, and you're like, oh, can I get Aux? And this is the first one you threw on.
You would never have Aux.
It'd be a tough
again.
Look.
You'd never have an Aux again.
He's not in the doghouse.
I was going to ask, how do you think this affects him as the artist?
He's consistent enough, like, he's not in the doghouse, you know?
I'd like to know more about these other two, because, like, maybe that's affecting how he made this song. Because, like, you know, with Garrix, when he did it with U2, like, that was an awful song.
Yeah.
Was it U2?
It was
U2.
Yeah.
That
Bottom and the Edge.
Yeah. So you're saying maybe the features clearly affected this.
It had an influence.
Because it sounded like
a
pop rap song.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
All right. So,
that's it.
I chose this, like, purposely. There's actually a pretty good spread. I like Weathen, at least some of his stuff, but I can confidently say I will not be saving this to my library or
hell no.
Listening to it ever.
Agreed.
Yeah, that's a no.
All right, we've got Mala or Flux.
All right, I'll go. We got Soul Trippin' by Mala. Mala is a French bass house DJ. No one knows his identity except for closely knit friends. So, like we were saying earlier, it, you know, could be one of us. Could be Ethan Sandy inside.
Could be.
But,
wait.
He's kind of a. Go ahead.
It could be Barker.
All right. Enough.
Jeez. All right. He's got kind of a badass narrative.
This guy, I think Hayden's underselling how much of a history we have with this guy.
You too.
I mean, I've seen him five times.
Wet for him. I mean, but he's
Will's, great, Will's so. Not really.
I'm downtrending on him personally.
I've seen him five times. We saw him in Chicago once, and to sum it up, it was one of the worst live experiences I can remember.
Shout out to Eric Colan. He was there with us. It was horrible. He's a part of a group called Pardon My French. Along with some other French DJs, and
Shaman,
there's
Mala, DJ Snake, Mercer,
which is a pretty badass group.
They're all
they're
dogs. They're fucking animals.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll
let's get into it. Right.
Yeah. He's been chopped at the
bit. I'm one for one. Mine last week was a dub. Just want to put that out there.
Yeah.
Can we turn it up a bit? Or maybe no. Wait. Hold on. That's just me. You're good. You're good. My bad.
Come on, Yes.
I don't even really know what to say.
I don't know how to feel about this one. Okay, so the buildup is
really a lot of buildup. It's a drop by him. It's kind of, what's the word? You could see it coming. Yeah, it's not a lot of continuity.
Can I hear that drop one more time?
Yeah,
I kind of need to reprocess that.
I don't know how that would sound on some serious headphones.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. It's not very loud right now.
Go to. Can we see? Here's the second drop. This it. Okay.
Hold on. This is the second part. That song is crazy.
Yeah.
Maybe not a good crazy, maybe not a bad crazy,
He played that at Otherworld.
Okay.
It was fun live.
So you've heard this before.
Yeah. I just recognized it from that show.
There is so many different sounds going on. It's hard to process everything. I like the beat drop.
Like the initial, I agree.
But like 5 seconds later, it completely drops off with those
sounds. He has that classic.
You've got like the bells. You've got the sirens. I agree. Right away, it's good.
Yeah.
The build up, there's like a cool like wavy sound. He didn't really stick with that much.
I would say this fits his style. It does.
When that bass line comes in,
the voice always shouting out.
Yeah.
I feel like that's always something he kind of does.
What do you guys think?
I like it.
Dub.
I would put it on occasionally, like screwing around for fun, like when you want like a high energy song.
I think I need to listen to this on my own, like, again. I think I'm going to like it, though. I like how different and how many different layers of the song there is.
All right, so a dub for you.
Yeah, I'll give it a dub.
On the binary scale, it's a 1.
So a dub.
Yeah.
I'll give it a dub, too. So 2-0.
But it wasn't an outstanding dub. It was a lot different than the usual.
I mean, like, would you guys listen to this by yourself and with other people? Would you work out to it?
The above, probably.
Okay.
Work out to it.
Okay.
I'd probably play it in a social setting.
Okay.
Dub.
I think it's cool enough that it would catch ears.
Okay.
It's very unique.
Okay.
All right. Finally.
All right.
We've got Chase's.
Flux Pavilion Symphony. Remix. How's it pronounced?
Hell's Loot.
Like we talked earlier, I didn't do any research. I'm gonna start doing that from now on. I think it's probably better for it.
You need to.
Yeah, I know. I like the original song, so that's why I chose the remix. A lot of potential for this, but not much else to say right now. I just kind of want to get into it and hear
it. Let's rip it. Let's
it goes. I love Flux. I love Flux. They made it really strong last time. Or he did. Sorry.
Yeah, I legit like, just zoned out.
Can we pause?
I like this personally.
It's the same thing for the how long?
I mean, it's just kind of like hopefully it's the build up where it lulls you to sleep and then it like goes off crazy.
What's the time at for this?
Any guesses?
Probably like 35 seconds.
Wrong. 48.
I literally like zoned out. That's so.
I'll get my take after this.
It's like a trance beat.
Get it off, get it off. That was like a firework that just never went off.
That's a good way to put it, yeah. The voice sounded pretty good, like right off the rip. She's got a nice voice.
Here's my take on this. So this was a very low-key energy song. But for 48 seconds, it was the same exact looping sound. The volume never went up, I don't think.
No.
Until they added an extra like layer sound at 48 seconds. But I guess I kind of just foretold what the song was gonna be. It was just no energy.
That must be a trance DJ.
Hell's Loot. Yeah. Not super high energy. I wouldn't save it. I could listen to it. Like, it's pretty easy to listen to.
Probably never listen to that again personally.
It is just too much of just nothing going on that I was never like looking forward to the alright, here comes the beat, like nothing.
I will say,
we can remixes.
There are probably multiple remixes to this song, and
yeah,
they usually kind of flop.
Yeah, you know, you can't beat Flux Pavilion himself. Maybe that's what it is.
Yeah. So you've gone back to back remixes. Maybe try to hit like an original track next week.
I'm gonna have to really do some research before next week, dude.
I'm low key in the doghouse myself, huh?
So
doghouse,
which was. I think the answer is clear, but which was worse, the We Thin or this?
We Thin.
I'd say this.
Wow!
Ooh, so
you would really like, if you were driving in a car, you'd rather listen to that over this?
At least the We Thin has a bit more to it than just like that little, you know, quick like bass line. That was boring. That was a waste of time listening to that song.
Yeah, I guess I would just rather have boring than like shitty.
That wasn't even EDM. We Thin song was not even EDM, I don't think. Was like,
they were both trash, but
you're the deciding factor. Which one was worse?
Oh, We Thin. Like I said, this isn't good, but like you can put it on. It's just
I agree with that.
Damn, dude, the bottom of my laptop is like a pool. Yeah. Holy cow. My legs are so sweaty.
You have to work on it.
It's a little clammy. we're gonna work to get a board up next week with our track record of this stuff. Yeah. We just kind of
keep
the ball.
Keep our records.
Yeah.
All right, that's fun.
Not good for me.
So, who's got the surprise of the week? Little treat.
I do. I went to Kroger right before this. This is
These chairs are so uncomfortable.
Yeah, I don't know why you guys didn't switch off for this thing.
So I got some crunchy kale. Brad's crunchy kale.
No.
Yikes.
Plant based. So we're gonna.
How healthy. Okay.
Yeah, there's a
plant-based
70 cows.
Why does it need to be plant-based?
So did you go in and just with no idea what you're gonna get, or have you been eyeing this for a week?
I had no clue. Okay. And honestly, the gas station would probably be better because there's so much at Kroger. It's like,
dude, no, listen to me. I went to that gas station, and It's candy and chips. They're all good. Like
the hell out of
here. Those fried pork rinds were the only thing I could find that was just like, oh, this is kind of something.
Really?
I
don't know. You think they'd have those at Kroger? The pork rind, whatever?
Yeah.
The pork chips?
Yeah, I think they would.
And our heater of the week, it's pretty highly regarded song in the house scene right now. Just came out a few weeks ago. Do It To It by, right? Do It To It?
Do It To It.
Yeah, by A-Craze. DJ Snake, you know, he's got his song up, the song of the summer. Like
he actually, the DJ himself has hailed it as going to be the track, the house track of the century.
The decade.
Who said that?
Which is the guy who made the song. He said he thinks the song has potential to be the house track of the decade, which is 10 years.
Yeah, that's 10 years.
Yeah. It's good. I get hype in your music and bringing the energy. I'm going to throw it on.
This song is the definition of a crowd pleaser.
Yeah.
All right, well,
have you heard this, Chase?
Yeah.
Oh, we just played it.
We played it pretty bad.
Oh, my God. Will's about to suck down the whole bag.
He's going to throw it in his fucking...
It's not the flavor. It's better than basic kale. All my ladies, pop your backs with it. Drop with it, lean with it, pop with it, snap with it. What do you think? All my
ladies, pop this?
Yeah. Looks like little like bud leaves. There. Can I get some more? All my ladies, pop your backs with it. Drop with it, lean with it, pop with it, snap with it.
Yeah,
it just looks so unappetizing. Yeah.
Ugh. Does just like dry your mouth out big time. Gives you that like crappy aftertaste.
Bro,
that's what I was going to say. The aftertaste is awful. Like they seasoned that shit up so much.
The consistency is... Yeah, those aren't good.
Funny how like they advertise the protein per bag, but like 6 grams just is not that much. I feel like.
And what's the servings on it?
It's per bag.
Oh.
So like.
No, not all. Well, it's
how much? Again, maybe this?
It's a worthy
$4.
Okay.
Kind of tax.
Okay.
That song, it came out recently.
A few weeks ago.
Yeah. Like we said, it's been played a lot of live shows.
God, that's awful.
You want a crowd pleaser if you're on Ox, you're gonna turn some heads with that.
Anybody looking for throw a heavy banger on at a party, put that to your list.
The DJ is definitely up and coming. I had never heard of him before this track. He doesn't have a ton of monthly listeners, but
no,
he's
lot
definitely
of,
growing.
Like, Snake plays a song, Mala plays a song, Dombrowski's played this song. It's all over the place. It's big.
That kale makes me like not hungry anymore.
Bro, that was gross. Buns.
It's like the aftertaste tastes like kind of like dirt.
So I'm
come on, Brad. Like you got to figure this out, pal.
I'm next week.
Oh,
mine is gonna be good.
You already got it up.
Hey, why don't you get us just like some pizzas or something?
Get us something good.
Like, Dewey's.
What about Long John Silver's? You come back with some fish and chips.
Go to a.
That would be funny.
Captain D's.
I would do that, but I can't anymore, dude. Captain D's, or I know it would be good is if I brought in shrimp and fries from Sharks, and then took like a video of me picking it up too.
Yeah, that'd be the best part.
Hey, why don't you come back with just 3 porterhouses from Ruby's? Oh.
Holy.
Yo, what you motherfuckers smiling at? Wipe that,
holy.
Wipe that smile off your face.
Why these motherfuckers in here smiling? I ain't never seen someone come in here smile like that.
So yeah, 2 weeks in. Thanks to those who have listened so far.
We know it's a lot.
And yeah, keep us coming with feedback. Anything you want us to talk about or do.
Yeah.
We're going to have a raffle. If your name's picked, you win $1 million. So keep listening.
I think we should probably like some kind of like...
If you comment on the video, you get entered into the raffle.
Yeah. And once we hit 1 million followers, then we'll do the raffle. So that's how that's going to work.
Don't say that.
Yeah.
We're not doing that.
We're not doing that. Unless
you guys got anything else... thanks for listening.
Let's wrap it up.
Just like Will said,
leave comments. Just give us some criticism. What we need to do better.
Tell us if we're really bad at this, really good.
We're the next party. My take.
Peace.
Bye.